yeah, there's only one type of person that can appreciate this shirt. You know what day it is. Pump day. And that's for each and every one of my gym stars. What's going on, everybody? It's your boy Jay Easy, aka Fresh from the Barbershop, BK the People's Champ, coming to you live with another video. Look, man, I hate when this happens, man. Hey, look, man, if you digging this shirt, man, let me know down in the comment section. We're gonna throw it up in the store, man. Pump day. Whoop whoop. Hey, that's the favorite day of the week for all of my gym stars, man. Look, brother, let me tell y'all something, man. We got a lot to talk about, a little bit of time to talk about it in, man. But first of all, I want to give a shout out to my guy on Twitter, man. Hey, my guy on Twitter said, hey, Jay, I saw your video about the badges. Well, let me see. Let me bring it back to right here real quick. He said, Jay, I saw the video about the badges for centers. I made the same one from your video on the center bills, but use these badges. They have me playing like a monster, but I'm going to try your badges. I think they can make me even better. Salute. Hey, salute to you too, my brother. And he showed, you know, he got the shooting glass cleaning lock, and he, you know, he's trying to get it maxed out and stuff like that. And these are the badges that he was using. Now, let me tell you, you're using pretty much the same badges that I use, my dog. The only thing is we ISO, so I don't have to use brick wall. So I'm able to put those 4 points somewhere else. But you got on Hall of Fame brick wall. If I did not have, if T didn't ISO or what have you, I would probably have on this exact same setup. But because T ISOs, I don't have to use brick wall. And so I'm able to put those badges somewhere else. So if you got a guard that ISOs, man, that's always a blessing, man, because I'm telling you, not having to run brick wall is one of the dopest things in the world, man. And really, you can get away with brick wall on silver if your point guard is really patient. But if you want those screens to really stick and really hit hard, then you gotta do that. But there's a way to set screens where you don't really gotta have brick wall and all this stuff, man. I'll probably tell y'all about that later, man, but yo, it is what it is. Anyway, man, first order of business, my guys. Look, Joe Knowles says, the legend grind is over. More than 10,000 viewers in the stream for someone who never streams. Wow, that's my guy right there, man, Joe Knowles. I appreciate all of you. So happy to never throw another lob again. Bangers on bangers on bangers on the way. And of course you get to see right here. Now, there you go, LeBron walking through the city. You know what I'm talking about. Hi, man. Y'all already know what it is, man. Hey, salute to Joe Knowles, man. He says he's one of my guys that used to watch my videos back in the day and all of that good stuff, man. He came through the stream one time, late, big lays. But the interior defense on this game is so broken. But he said, you know, he used to watch my Raising with Randoms and all of that. Bro, I got a lot of people that used to watch my videos that are up there now. But a lot of times, you know, we get so busy caught up in our grind or what have you. He on Xbox and stuff too. That's probably why I ain't never been able to run with him. But you know, he came through the stream one day and hit me up. And he was like, yo, your ways with randoms used to have me weak back in the day, man. And so, you know, hey, gotta show my man love, man. Anybody that grinds out this game to the tune of 10,000, like, I don't know how many games he played, but I know it's damn near 10,000 or something like that to get legend. Now the ridiculous, I mean, if you grind the game out and you get to legend, you deserve those 30 extra badges, my boy. I mean, 40 extra badges, 10 extra per category. I'm not gonna count. Whoa, do you know how broken his build is gonna, trays up, splash down. Do you know how broken his build is gonna be now? Bro, that build gonna be completely busted. Like, oh my God, he got the LeBron build and he's got the shooting badges. So now he can go downhill and he gonna have 10 extra badges per category, not to mention the defensive badges that he's gonna have. But if, bro, the builds that he can make, it's just gonna be stupid. I ain't gonna lie to y'all, bro. The scariest build in this game when it comes to that, to legend, y'all let me know what y'all think down in the comments. I'm gonna give y'all 5 seconds. What's the scariest legend build? I'm gonna tell you the scariest legend build. All right, 5 seconds is up. Let's go. The scariest legend build is easily the two-way slashing playmaker. Just think about that. The two-way slashing playmaker. you get like the one that me and T was building, bro. You get you at the, you okay? So you get 10 finishing, like off the bat, you get 10 finishing, 10 shooting, 19 playmaking, 19 defensive. So that's 29 defensive, 29 playmaking, 20 shooting, and 20 finishing at Legend. And we already see that Bill can shoot threes. And if you make him a certain way, I think at a 90, if you make him a certain way at a 97, which everybody can hold 97, at a 97, you'll have a 73 ball. And then at a 98, 99, which if you're a point guard, you should be able to hold the regular 99. You're gonna have a 72. All I got is a 73 three ball, bro, and I don't miss. Just think about that. And then if you got somebody on the floor with anything to boost you, bro, you good to go, man. It is what it is, bro. That build is tough. That two-way slashing playmaker is tough, especially once you get it there. But you got to get it there, though, man. Are you going to grind it out if you make one? If you going to, you know what I'm saying? Are you going to do that stuff right there? Are you going to do what's necessary in order to get it there? That's what the question is. Anyway, man, up next, man, we got my boy Running 2K. Hey, man, hey. He's doing, they're saying, the Make-A-Wish Foundation. My boy Buddy is, I guess that episode is going to go live or what have you. They're going to do some more stuff, or they're going to, you know, put everything out there that they did when they did the Make-A-Wish. Buddy, my guy, man. Buddy's a guy that supported me the last couple of years. You know, he comes to the streams. He, I follow him on Instagram, follow him on Twitter and stuff like that. We have, you know, we talk back and forth. We do all this stuff, man. So Buddy's a cool dude, and he used to be the point guard with ATL. I'm trying to get Buddy to come run some point guard for me for when T ain't around. But, hey, it is what it is, because he don't want to play with me. I guess I ain't got enough clout for you, huh, Buddy? But, hey, it is what it is, man. I ain't mad at it. But, yeah, I'm trying to get him. Oh, my God, I should have edited that out. Jabby. Bro, them hop steps be ridiculous. Let me tell you what happens on that. If they got fancy footwork, if you don't already jump, when they're getting ready to go up, you got no chance. It'll just throw you in the animation. So if they got fancy footwork and slithery, see, look, this is what I did to him the next time. I already knew what he was gonna try to do, make him look stupid. Now, you know, dumbass. Anyway, when you play, I mean, like I said, man, I used to play with Buddy. I'm trying to get Buddy to run with me, you know, when T's not on or whatever, man. But you know, hey, it is what it is. I guess I ain't got enough clout for Buddy. But anyway, his the Make-A-Wish episode and all of that information should be coming out tomorrow, man. I hope it's awesome. I hope they put it on. Buddy, if I'm wrong, let me know down in the comment section what they're actually going to do, man, because I don't know. You know, I really don't know what's going to happen. Are they just going to show the episode? They're going to give the information? They're going to show everything that you guys did and all that? Did you help plan 2K21? All of that stuff right there, man. Inquiring minds would like to know. And then last but not least, man, check it out. Your boy, Drippy Drew, had a question for everybody's favorite Mike Wong. And that question was, this is a real quick question for you, Mike. Does Steady Shooter, the badge, cancel out my shooting badges boost? I mean, cancel out my other shooting badges boost that they give. I guess you're saying the boost that the other shooting badges give, such as catch and shoot, difficult shots, what's that? HZH, I don't know what the hell that is. Green Machine, Hot Zone Hunter, Green Machine, and Hot Start, much more, but just need a breakdown. Alright, so y'all not gonna be able to tell, but my recording equipment did die on me right there for a second, but hey, it is what it is, man. We good to go. Like he said, look, I just need a breakdown, is what he said. And Mike Wong comes back and says, it won't cancel. First of all, let me show y'all something real quick right here, boy. 10.9 points a game. This is a sweat game, baby. He out here sweating on the sticks. But it's going to be a tough game. Lawrence, go crazy. Let's get it. But Mike comes back and says, it won't cancel the other badges out, but dampens their impact a little. A little. 2K never quantifies what a little is or what a lot is. Is it going to be noticeably dampened? Is it just going to dampen it, you know, just enough just to say that it is dampened? So anyway, one dude says, the badge is horrible. I took it off and I'm shooting lights out again. Never experimenting again. And I can see that. Somebody else came back and said, sad you kids still asking these questions in March. Same type kids who wanted the behind the back gone. Nah, This guy right here that we played against is probably one of those kids that wanted the behind the back gone. But hey, you're going to see how this going to turn out. I mean, wanted the behind the back in the game. He wanted the behind the back still in the game. But, you know, it is what it is. I don't know why people always got to take shots like that. And then one dude says, I think the steady shooter on Silver is a good balance for smart shooters. And then one dude says, this is a terrible take. And last but not least, he says that Trey's up, splash down. He says that Silver steady shooter is good. That's a bad take. And he said the lower tier it is, the worse it is. You either want it Hall of Fame or nothing. And that's definitely something that we've heard from people. And we had 2K Toots tested out. And we also had, my guy All City Live TV, he tested it out. And a couple people tested it out, man. But they're behind the back, the same people that wanted it behind the back gone. Bro, listen, man, if you wanted that move still in the game, you a fucking bum, bro. Like, there are so many other moves in this game that you can use. Imagine this game on lunch, just how it was. We had fading threes, the behind the back, and the hop step. Bro, this game would be completely busted. You wouldn't be able to guard anybody. Like, I just don't get that. Like, people love saying that the behind the back gone and it ain't coming back. It's never coming back. They never intended it for it to be in the game in its current iteration. And they knew that if they left it in the game, only thing that people were going to do in the 2K League was just behind their back to freedom. They don't want that same type of repetitive gameplay. It's never coming back. Now, hey, if you can't play without it and you still crying about it, imagine still crying about the behind the back being gone in March. Just think about it like that. Like, you saying something about it, but just think about that. Imagine talking about the behind the back being gone in March. You still crying about some shit that was broke, a broken mechanic. Anyway, look, steady shooter. Let's get on to that. I feel like it's one of those badges where, hey, if you got luxury to put it on, you got like 30 shooting badges, maybe put it on, something like that. If you play rec or a game mode where, you know, people gonna be standing right on top of your feet a lot and stuff like that, and you know, it's not much space to take shots and stuff, perhaps. But I other than that, I really don't see a use for it, because I just take good shots. I don't even raise up if somebody's near me. Woo! Look at that Darth Vader back in the building. I don't even raise up if somebody's not near me. And if they are near me and I do raise up because I didn't think they were going to get the closeout animation and they do, I have bailout on, so I don't use it at all. I feel like I just take really good smart shots, and you really don't even need that badge. I feel like you don't even need steady shooter. But I can definitely see some situations where you would use it. Steady shooter, do you? Don't flop now! Don't flop now! T was trying to, he tried to size up and shoot a three, but they didn't let him do it. But anyway, if you do use it, I can definitely see some situations where it would be useful, because they said it doesn't just help when people are closing now. I mean, are in your face. It helps when they're standing there and not contesting the shot. So it helps for the contest that you get when you're just standing in the area. So probably helps with the effects of Intimidator is what I'm going to say. It really does. But if we got Bronze Dead after that, I don't even see why. Like, you don't even got to put Dead Eye on anything past Bronze, really, in this game. So I really feel like you really don't need Steady Shooter. And the reason, I mean, like I said, just take good smart shots, and Steady Shooter is one of those moot badges. It's just like what I was saying with my boy when, you know, Judge was talking about, like, we ISO, so there's no need for me to use brick wall. So it's the same thing with steady shooter. I don't take bad shots, so the badge would be useless to me. I'm not going to dampen my badges and knock down my shooting percentage or my chances of hitting the shot by like 5% or greater. If, I mean, just for the fact that when somebody's there, I might be able to hit a shot with somebody in my face. You understand what I'm saying? Like, I don't want to do that. Now, you might think that, because they said, I think that it knocks everything down like 5%. And you may think that 5% is not a lot, but bro, they said that turning your shot meter off is only a 5% increase. And look what that does for a lot of people. We can't even shoot with the shot meter off no more. You understand what I'm saying? So without that little boost, or without the 5%, or without being able to completely just concentrate on your guy's biomechanics, we can't even shoot. You know what I'm saying? Like, you can't even shoot with the shot meter. So that 5% is definitely a lot. I'm not willing to sacrifice the 5%. But if you are like a 98, right on his ass, T! Hey, if you are somebody that's got like a 90 shot, or like an 85, or high 80s, or high 90s, you could probably sacrifice it and be the same way, and you're looking for all the badges that you have right there. But like I said, this steady shooter didn't help him right there. T didn't get a hand up and none of this stuff. So it is what it is, man. It really just depends on the player. And look, Trey's up, splash down. Look at Joker right there. Joker, I had to ask Joker too. I said, bro, you got on steady shooter? He said, nah. Look at this. This dude a lock, man. He right there. It don't matter. Green Bean Money Team. So if you take smart shots and you take quick shots, you got a quick enough jump shot, I don't feel like you need steady shooter. There are obviously some times where I guess it would benefit you. And if you have an abundance of badges, I would probably use it. But other than that, I really don't see why, you know, why you would use steady shooter. And like I said, this is Lawrence Go Crazy. Hey, I guess he one of them guys, look, 0 for 6, man. He can't even make a shot without the behind the back and stuff like that. So, you know, it is what it is, man. IQ trumps a whole lot. I ain't gonna say it trump everything, because you do gotta have some skill, but IQ trumps a whole lot. Anyway, man, hope you guys enjoyed the video, man. Let me know what y'all think down in the comments. Like I said, I need to know, steady shooter, do you use it? Will you use it? How do you feel about it? Is it a waste of a badge, or is it something that you would use? And what build do you think is going to be the most busted build at Legend? Like I said, I think the two-way slashing playmaker is going to be that. And last, but and one more thing, man. Let me tell y'all something, man. Point guards, this is, if you're not a point guard, click off the video right now. Just click off the video. If you're not a point guard, click off the video. We done talking to everybody else. We only talking to point guards right now. Click off the video if you're not a point guard. All right, point guards. Now that it's just me and you here, let's have some real talk. And it's not cap. The last 3 days, me and T have been experimenting. He took off, he was playing the one-on-one courts. So he took off Dimer and he took off Floor General. So we out there playing raw, just shooting raw. I missed 5 shots in 2 days with him not having that on, because I didn't know. And then he just said, yo, I'm like, yo, something different. I'm just spraying out here. He's like, I don't know, because I definitely ain't got on no Floor General or no Dimer. He took it off and we shooting better. Maybe your guys will shoot better too. If y'all take it off, just take it off. Try it a couple of games. Take off the Floor General. Take off the Diamond. Just see what they do, man. If they suck it up, they suck it up. But I'm just saying, hey, it's worth a shot, man. You got more badges for yourself. And you can break more ankles. You can create more space. Space creator, ankle breaker, all this stuff. T killing right now. And I told him, don't even put it back on. He's like, damn, I ain't got on Floor General. I might need to put it there. Don't you put that shit back on. Leave it off. Be selfish, motherfucker. I ain't studying that shit. I ain't missing, Joke. I ain't missing. Leave it off. But anyway, y'all try. See if y'all can be more creative. No Floor General, no Diamond, man. See what it is. If you can shoot, you can shoot. Shooters gonna shoot, man. And I'm out at y'all next time. But if your guys start bricking, you might want to turn it back on. But I'm out of here till next time. That's your boy, Jay Easy, a.k.a. Fresh from the Barbershop, BK the People's Champ. Godspeed.